Auckland sees the end of an epic journey to and from the top of the world, and a crowd of thousands waits to welcome New Zealand's heroes. From aboard the Solent flying boat, Sir Edmund Hillary and George Lowe emerge to report all's well to the men and women who in spirit were never far behind them. Fellow alpinists and many others struggled for a foothold, and none was prouder of the hero than his nephew, John. This was not the civic welcome, but a truly spontaneous greeting by his admirers and friends. All the excuse they needed was they were fellow New Zealanders. As George Lowe spoke his piece, he was watched with pride by Hillary's parents and Sir John Allam, Mayor of Auckland. And did their listeners give them a hand? In his hometown, Papakura, Hillary was greeted not only by the mayor, but by the town's school children who'd been given a special half holiday. Following one more civic reception was reunion with his family, and none more pleased to see him than his brother Rex.
What do you consider were the highlights of your trip to Everest?
Well, I suppose the main highlights were the actual bits on the mountain itself. The ice fall, perhaps, was the most interesting thing. We were nervous a good deal of the time, and some of the bits of ice hanging overhead, so it made a rather keen impression on us. And with me especially, I think, the last summit effort, mm-hmm. from the South Col to the top, naturally I'll remember for some time.
Yes. What about that rock step? It was fairly steep, wasn't it?
Yeah, it wasn't too bad. I was a bit worried about it at first and thought that we wouldn't get up it. But fortunately there was a crack between the ice and the rock. Mm-hmm. I got into this and I was able to wriggle my way up it.
Yes. Mm. And you had to use your spikes and handholds, what you could find, did you?
Yes, I used the spikes on my boots on the ice behind me, mm. and just held onto any old handhold I could find on the rock in front.
Yes. And I believe George Lowe did a very fine job.
Yes, George did extremely well. Mm. He did a jolly good job on the Lhotse face, which is, ranges from about 22 to 25,000 feet. Mm. And really, he was meant to have been washed out on that, but he wouldn't remain done in, and later on, he carried the highest camp up to nearly 28,000 feet.
And he put in a phenomenal time on the Lhotse face, didn't he, at that height?
Yes, he was there for nearly 9 days, mm. and I think that's probably the longest time anybody's ever spent at that height.
Mm. Yes. Now, after climbing Everest, what are your impressions of the New Zealand mountains?
Well, I think you still think the New Zealand mountains are extremely fine ones. In fact, we have wonderful mountains here. They have so much snow and ice on them that they give wonderful training for the Himalayas. Mm. Our weather here is so bad that we have to be extremely careful with our climbing. And just as we on Everest took every care and consideration with the result that we had no casualties at all, I think in the New Zealand Alps you have to use very sound judgment, mm. and a considerable amount of care in our very difficult conditions.
Mm.